I think it's great. I think the opportunities are terrific. But the biggest piece for me, and most important piece, is that you've got a big youth program here and the ability to build additional youth fields. And so that I can do the tournament baseball for kids that I've wanted to do for a very long time. And the rest of it sort of flows out from there. In the end, our lease is coming up in Utah. And I wanted to do a youth program in Utah for a very, very long time. Ultimately couldn't get it done there. Started to look at a half a dozen cities that work within the Pioneer League demographic and geography, Pueblo being one of them. I sat on the board for and coached for 33 years in Encino, California. My dad was the president. My dad, who's in town with me, was the president for a while. I played there. It's still the district that we live in. And I coached my brother. I coached my sister. I coached my sister-in-law. I coached my kids for years and years. There are a couple thousand kids that walk around. Not kids anymore. They're adults now, but they call me coach. Big part of who I am and what I do. And it's all about kids. So youth sports, not just baseball, but youth sports in general, is a booming business. And what's happened now is sort of the park league free sports concept has morphed into the travel tournaments for all sports. And baseball is a big part of that. It's a $10 billion industry and growing right now. People now spend their summers running around with their kids in youth tournaments. And again, whatever sport it is, you're seeing these pop up all over the place. It's a phenomenon. It ain't going anywhere. It makes sense here in Pueblo. Again, you've got the facility, you have the people, you have the downtown, you've got all these things to do in Pueblo. You've got a beautiful state park. You've got all these other activities. People now use their vacation dollars to travel around with their kids playing sports. And you want to have it in a place that's a vacation spot. And Pueblo is a vacation spot. And we're going to help make it a better vacation spot. It's going to bring, when it's up and running in full, and it'll take about 3 years once we get started to get it to capacity. You'll have about 500 families a week here for about 14 weeks. Most of them are tourists because they're coming in from other places. Our goal is to average about 3,000 a night. There are nights that you'll have 5,000 or 6,000 in there. There are nights you may have 1,500 in there, We ain't coming without the hotel space. None of it comes without the hotel space. You don't have, your hotels are full now, which is great. You need more hotel rooms without me. The OWLS as an organization use about 1,300 room nights in a 90-day period in the summer. For sure, I do that every year. The youth piece of this thing, think about where 500 families a week are gonna stay and how many hotel rooms you need. We had the initial conversation actually in Arizona, and then I came out to Pueblo a couple weeks later, and the first thing I said was, you don't have any rooms here, I can't come. You have to have more hotels. And they said, well, we need someone to build them. And I said, well, I build hotels. Now you have sort of a three-piece process. You have the youth piece, you have the stadium piece, and the hotel piece. None of them work without the other. So we have to have the hotels. They have to be open by the time we move the team here, because it doesn't work otherwise. So we'll build, three hotels, maybe even a fourth down the line, They'll be nationally branded. I'm connected to that. We're already in discussions with brands. I haven't figured out which ones I want to do yet. We'll build a limited service hotel for sure. We'll do probably a 3.5, maybe a 4-star full service hotel. And then the third one is sort of a to be determined. The third one will wait a little bit. The first two will be about 110 to 120 rooms apiece. We're going to put some residential piece in the full service as well as some apartments. I'm going to put myself a house on top of it so I have a place to live when I'm here. The third one will wait a little bit to see the need, and the size of that will be determined. It'll still be the Owls. The first name will change, not the last name. We spent a lot of time branding and marketing. We'll change some of the logo sets to incorporate, the locale here, but we'll keep the Owls name. We are hoping to have first pitch here in 2020.
Minor league baseball, wherever it seems to go, because it's such a family thing to do, always works. And nowadays, it's baseball is going through some interesting issues with trying to really activate kids again. That's not a problem.